my privilege at this point in time to invite Cheri Fish forward. I saw her earlier in the assembly. Cheri is someone I also got to know as LWML is a registered service organization. Would you please welcome Ms. Cheri Fish?
Thank you, President Meyer. Thank you for the opportunity to bring greetings from the Michigan District LWML, the Executive Committee, Board of Directors, and the almost 6,000 members of the LWML here in Michigan. God has truly blessed the LWML here in Michigan, and I would like to share some of those blessings with you. First of all, we will be hosting our 34th biennial convention next month at the Hyatt Regency in Dearborn under the theme, Now Go. Based on Exodus 4:12, our objective is to inspire attendees to know that with confidence from God, they can proclaim the freedom we have in Christ Jesus. We are very excited that both President Harrison and President Meyer will be participating in our opening worship service and bringing greetings to the convention. Our convention attendance averages around 800. And I was thrilled this past weekend to find out that we have so far 114 first-time attendees registered, and that's phenomenal for us. We have already met one of the goals of our convention is that we want to have women involved in the Word of God. 3 weeks ago, I received notification from our registrar that we had filled 3 Bible studies already, which we've never done before. We had over 400 women already registered for Bible studies. Well, there was a big problem. We had 7 weeks to go before convention. What are we going to do with everybody that registers in those 7 weeks? So I found another pastor who graciously offered to lead a Bible study, and we now have close to 500 women registered for Bible study pre-convention. God continually blesses our efforts in mission work. Coupled with our national Mike goal of $1.8 million, our Michigan district goal for Mike giving this biennium was $230,000, plus a 25% that we send to the national LWML. By the grace of God and the generosity of our women, we were able to pay out all of our mission grants for this biennium. We have seen the We have seen how God has worked mightily with the use of our Mite money. This year, the National LWML celebrates 70 years of existence in the LCMS, and we have reached $100 million raised for mission work in that time. Now, that's through Mite offerings, mostly just loose change. Next month, the Michigan District is celebrating 68 years as part of the LWML, and I am so very proud to report that we as a Michigan District LWML have contributed $2.9 million towards that $100 million raised. We are very thankful to God for the generosity of our women. I would like to share some blessings the Michigan District has experienced specifically during these past 4 years during my presidency, which I will complete next month. We have funded scholarships for 62 Michigan seminarians at both Fort Wayne and St. Louis seminaries. We have provided scholarships for 36 Michigan female students studying for full-time church work in the LCMS through the Deaconess Program and our Concordia University system. Our mission goal of $230,000 in both biennia provided funding for most ministries, Lutheran City Ministries in Detroit, Lutheran Special Education Ministries, Open Arms Daycare Centers, as well as 29 other ministries in Michigan, the U.S., and internationally. The LWML also provided hands-on, short-term mission opportunities for women in partnership with most ministries. We have sent 48 women into the mission field to Costa Rica, Poland, Slovakia, Panama, Honduras, Cambodia, Guatemala, and Nicaragua. Additionally, in these 4 years, the Michigan District began providing in-state mission trips to encourage women to do hands-on mission work in their own backyard without having to leave the country. We worked with Lutheran City Ministries and Family of God in Detroit. Women and men together worked at the Latino Mission Society in Southwest Detroit. Last summer, we spent a week mobilizing women to partner with Lutheran Child and Family Services at their Grand Rapids, Bay City, and Farmington Hill locations, all in 1 week's time. At the end of July, we will be working at St. Paul Pontiac, providing a VBS and women's ministry opportunity for the church and the community. Through our Heart to Heart Sisters program, we are intentionally teaming the LWML with LCMS women of different cultures and ethnicities. We are currently working with the Hmong woman from Our Savior in Lansing, and we welcomed the African Women's Ministry LWML as a new society formed by women comprising Sudanese and Ethiopian women from Living Word Lutheran Church worshiping at Trinity Lansing. One of the challenges we do face as an organization is that societies are disbanding, some due to churches closing, some merging of congregations, others because the age of their members. Let's face it, 68 years, we're an aging organization. But we also have a history of women partnering with their congregations and being actively involved in Bible study and service to the church. The vision of the LWML is that we be a representation of the women of the LCMS, women of all ages and stages of life, many different cultures and ethnicities, truly a diverse population. I was privileged to speak to the fourth-year graduates at the Fort Wayne Seminary last month. The one question asked by several pastor-elects was that they knew that the churches they've been called to did not have LWML societies. And the question was, how do we start one? What do we do? And I told them, Bible study, Bible study, Bible study, and more Bible study. You start from there. Get the women involved in the word, and the rest will grow. We are seeking new and creative ways for the busy women of the 21st century to be involved in the ministry of the LWML and their individual congregations. We are providing mentoring opportunities to our younger women to introduce LWML to them. We are intentionally working with teens to be a part of our Friends Into Serving Him program to introduce them to the LWML. First and foremost, the vision of the Lutheran Women's Missionary League would be Lutheran women in mission, who are in the Word and in a daily walk relationship with their Lord. Pastors, I specifically want to thank you for your support of the LWML in your congregations. Please continue to encourage and inspire your women to be in Bible study, outreach, and service in your local congregations. To those of you that don't have an LWML presence in your congregation, please be open in encouraging them to be a part of this vital ministry. If you and your congregation are not participating with the LWML in your mission walk, then now is the time to go and take that walk with the LWML. Pastors, we want to partner with you in mission service, mission education, and mission awareness. Help us to achieve the mission of the LWML, which is to assist each woman of the Lutheran Church Missouri Synod in affirming her relationship with the triune God, so that she is enabled to use her gifts in ministry to the people of the world. Please help to encourage your women to be confident to now go. President Meyer, I have a gift for you from the LWML, in a purple bag and everything. It's my hope that since you're going to be joining us at the convention next month, that you will consider wearing this. Not the bag.
Not the bag, okay. Thank you.